All right, here's a close-up of the Road Agent by ATI 12-gauge, 18.5-inch coach gun.
What's up, YouTube? Hot Litter Tired here. All right, guys, I got a new gun. I got the other day. And the only reason I bought this gun is I'm going to do a Form 1 short-barreled shotgun. I always wanted to do a double barrel. And I bought the cheapest double barrel I could find because I didn't want to cut off a barrel off of an expensive shotgun. Just couldn't do it. I'm waiting on my Form 1 on another shotgun. It's a Shockwave. My paperwork's been in for 63 days, so it's not approved yet. So whenever that gets approved and I get my stock and put it on there, I'll put a video up. All right, guys, this is the new ATI Road Agent model. It's an 18.5-inch, 12-gauge, double barrel. It comes with 5 chokes. This is in their line of the Cavalry lineup, and they make a 28-inch barrel too, 12, 20, 28, and 410, I believe. And they also have an over and under shotgun in that series. It's got an aluminum receiver, which I really don't care for that. I didn't even know it was aluminum until I got home. But it is lightweight. It only weighs about 5.6 pounds, something like that. It's got a pretty good recoil pad on it. It looks good. The engraving's kind of cheesy. It's engraved everywhere. That's some laser engraving, and it's real, like, it's not very deep. But the only problem is, when I got home, I was trying to find a place where I was going to put my NFA engraving on here. And it's engraved everywhere. It's engraved on the bottom. And the trigger guard is a removable trigger group, so I can't engrave it on that, but it's engraved there anyway. So I called my guy that does my engraving and stuff, and he's a FFL, SOT, and he's a gun manufacturer, and he does a lot of clear coat. He does everything, man. But he told me I'm gonna sand some of this engraving off the bottom part here and give him enough space where he can engrave my NFA stuff. I'm gonna anodize the aluminum. I guess that's what you call it. Anodize it. Make it black, but it won't match. This is a pretty nice little finish they got on here, but I'll probably never be able to match it. But as long as I get it dark, yeah, I don't care. Plan on cutting it down to about 9 3/8-inch barrels. That's as far as I can go without losing any checkering on my forearm. So I'm gonna have to cut about an inch and a half off the forearm to get it there. I wanna leave the checkering on there because it's pretty deep and it does give you some traction. The crazy thing about this gun is on this side, it has a lever here, and it's safe, fire, and decock. So, let me just show you. This thing automatically cocks the hammers when you break it down. I'll show you that right now. Keep an eye on the hammers. See how they cock back? And so right now it's in I got it in safe mode right now. You can't pull the triggers, so the hammers won't fall. You move this down one notch and that's the fire position, and you can fire it again. And then you move it up to the decock, you can decock these hammers. I'll show it to you. and you can decock the hammers with the loaded gun and they won't hit the firing pin. So when you got it on decock and it's loaded and you want to shoot it, say a few minutes later, you can cock them by hand and shoot it just like a regular double barrel shotgun. And you can also decock the triggers by pulling the trigger and letting the hammer down. But they don't recommend that in the owner's manual. They recommend using the decock system, which I like the decock system. I kind of like it's a safety and everything on it, really. I mean, it took me a little bit to get used to it. Like I said, it comes with 5 choke tubes. 3-inch chamber, so it'll shoot the 3-inch stuff. What else can I tell you about it? It weighs 5.6 pounds. It's imported from ATI, from Turkey. The barrel is a carbon steel barrel. And it's got some kind of, it's not Creocote. They said it's a blued, with a black aluminum finish on it. So I don't even know what that means. But it looks okay. It's not a shiny black, it's kind of like a matte black, but that's good. It's got some checkering down here on the grip part, which is good. And the wood looks good too, guys. It's not bad looking wood. There's the bottom of it. It's really light. It's gonna be a little lighter when I cut some barrel off of that. But anyway, that's what I'm planning on doing with it, guys. I haven't shot it yet. I'm going to take it to the range probably Tuesday is my day that I got open, or maybe tomorrow. I could go tomorrow. If my son wants to go with me and shoot it, I'll go Tuesday because he's off of work Tuesday. If he doesn't want to go, I'll just go Sunday by myself and shoot it. Anyway, stay tuned for that video. And guys, I searched YouTube looking for a video where somebody is actually shooting this gun, and I can't really find anything. There's like maybe 5 videos on YouTube about this gun. I don't know how new it is. I don't know when it came out. I don't know if it's just a budget gun, guys. It was under $500. My gun store had it. I just went ahead and got it. Because I've always wanted a double barrel sawed off shotgun. So, and I've been putting it off and putting it off. And I said, the next time I find a gun that's got hammers on it and it's really cheap, I'm gonna get it and saw it off. So, anyway, that's about all I can say because I haven't shot it. I hope it shoots good. I want to make sure it shoots before I spend $200 for a tax stamp. You know what I mean? So, and I don't know how long it'll take. I'm doing it on a gun trust, and it's just, I'm dreading doing it. Because every time I do it, I got to go around and get everybody's fingerprints, everybody's picture, photos. And I got to upload my trust to their website, ATF or ATF's website. I got to upload our photos. I got to upload a picture of the gun now. They're making us do a picture of the markings on the gun that you're planning on working on. And in my case, we got to print out the responsible person's form for everybody in the trust, print them out, and then they have to sign them. Then I have to scan them in the scanner into my computer, and I got to send those in. I got to upload those and send those in on a file. They're wrecking it hard on an old man, guys. I ain't used to this computer stuff. I think I worked 5 or 6 hours on that thing last time trying to figure out everything. I still don't know if I got it yet. I'm worried about it. It's been 63 days. I don't know. It might get passed. It might go through. I don't know. I think I've done everything right. It's not my first one. I've got like 7 or 8 NFA items. But it's my first sawed-off shotgun. And this will be my second. Well, it'll be my first sawed-off shotgun when I get the approval back, I guess. I might not get it. Hell, I don't know. All right, guys. Well, thanks for watching. Hot Lead Retired out of here.